All right. Well, welcome to my show. I am so excited to be here with you guys today. And today I'm going to be talking about 6 tips to improve your brain's health and to help prevent dementia. And as many of you know, the brain is the computer system of your body. Without a functioning brain, your body isn't going to function well. And in addition to that, you have billions of brain cells. Billions of brain cells. And so it's important to protect them. And these cells, by the way, are called neuron. And so when I talk about these tips, I'm going to use neuron, N-E-U-R-O-N, as the framework. The other thing is, by the way, we don't have a lot of research to show once someone has really severe cognitive impairment, we don't have research to show how to reverse those. Right? So the best tool that you have is to prevent and to catch it early. And these are tips that anyone can use. Now, if you are new to my page or new to me, my name is Dr. Diane Thompson. I'm triple board certified in physical medicine and rehabilitation, in brain injury medicine, and in lifestyle medicine. And I'm able to combine those three things to do things that I'm very passionate about. For example, I help people with neurological disabilities, and I help them to adjust, to adapt, and attain a new normal and a new lease on life. And also for people who are just trying to get healthy or stay healthy, those with chronic diseases, because of my lifestyle medicine training, I can help them with lifestyle medicine strategies to help prevent, halt, and even reverse some chronic diseases. Some of these diseases we know are lifestyle-related diseases, so we know how to change our health, change our lifestyle to make an impact on those diseases. The important thing I want to mention to you here is that this information is for educational purposes only. I don't know you personally, and this is the case for any show that you listen to, any piece of information you get on online. No one knows you directly like your doctor does. So you take that information, it's education, it's information, you go back to your doctor and you say, hey, this is the information I've heard, what do you think? So that person can help you make the changes to your health. All right, so we're gonna jump into it. These are 6 tips to help improve your brain's health and to help prevent dementia. Tip number one, it to me is the biggest, the most impactful, and the one that everyone should be aware of. And it's the N for nutrition. Remember, we're going to use the framework of neurons, right? Neurons are brain cells. They're nerve cells, and your brain cells are called neurons. There are specific types in the brain, but in general, they're neurons. So neuron will be what I'm using today. So the N is for nutrition. That's huge. Nutrition, I don't think many of us realize the importance of it, right? Nutrition is huge. And what I will tell you in general is a whole food plant-based nutrition. I am not someone who pushes, I don't say vegetarian or vegan or paleo or all these different types of things that are out there, in my opinion, to get your money, because you put a label on something, you can sell it, right? Whole food plant-based nutrition, you just go to the farmer's market, you go to your backyard, or you go to the store and you get it, right? There's no one that's going to make money from that. And I've actually met people. So over the years, many of you know, I've had a health show, Health Talk with Dr. Diane MD, for years. And I've interviewed people that were vegetarian and vegan and they were obese. Why? Because potato chips would be technically vegetarian and can be vegan, but it's not whole food, right? So you would eat the potatoes if you wanted whole foods, right? You would eat the apple if you wanted whole foods. So whole food would be the actual plant, the actual fruit or vegetable, as close as you can get to natural as possible, right? So whole food plant-based. So the N for nutrition, that's huge. Studies have shown that berries, the green leafies, those are really important in protecting the brain. And that's how you're going to get that if you eat like that. So what's the tip? The tip that you're going to use in order to get more of this type of food in your nutrition is to reimagine foods like breakfast, right? We've been taught that breakfast should be cereal foods. And I often tell people, That came, the people came up with that were people who sell breakfast cereal. I had a lunch meeting with someone a couple of weeks ago when we went to a place and I had sauteed green vegetables for breakfast. It was so delicious. It was warm. I like warm meals. And it was great. And that was breakfast. So you have to reimagine your meals and don't think that your meal has to be a certain way. And if you reimagine breakfast, you can start that meal with that whole food plant-based. The second tip, and remember we're going N-E-U-R-O-N. So E, exercise, that's also simple. Listen, most of us know by now, the studies have definitely shown us that if you are exercising, that's a really important thing for your brain. There have actually been studies that show that elderly who took a brisk 40-minute walk, and that actually that could help to improve their cognitive status. So exercise, start working out. And so the question often asked is, what's the best exercise? And it's the one that you'll actually do. So find something you'll do and get going. The E, N-E-U, we talked about exercise. Now the U is for unwind. We live in a very stressful world. And we actually know that a lot of those hormones from stress will affect every organ in our bodies, and they definitely will affect the brain. Chronic exposure to stress will affect your brain in a negative way, will affect your memory. It actually shows that people are chronically exposed to stress, that their brain will actually shrink. It will be smaller. Parts of the brain, like the hippocampus that has to do with memory and thinking, those parts of the brain are not as big as in people who are not exposed to a lot of stress. So what's a tip to deal with this? Learn to meditate. That's huge. And I'm going to talk in another show about all the benefits. I'm going to look at all the research on meditation because that is huge in itself. So learn to meditate. There are free meditation apps. There are also you can go on YouTube. There are channels dedicated to meditation. If you want to learn to meditate, you can learn to meditate and it won't cost you a thing. The R is for restorative sleep. You guys have known me for a while. You know I've always had to work on this because sleep doesn't come easy for me. So I usually have to work on it. So restorative sleep. What the studies show is on average 7 to 9 hours. It actually shows that less sleep as well as more sleep. So too much sleep. When they look at the nurses' health study, people who were sleeping 10, 11 hours, that also was detrimental to their cognitive health, to their brain's health, and to other aspects of their health. So too much is not good either. So we're looking for optimal sleep, but it also should be restorative sleep, meaning that you don't want to go to sleep and wake up still feeling sleepy. And there are people who've done that. They'll sleep for the 7 or 8 hours, but they still wake up feeling sleepy and tired. When that happens, you do need to talk with your doctor. Sometimes it's sleep apnea and you don't know that. And so you may be having good quantity of sleep, but your quality is lacking, right? So you want to get that checked out. The other thing now, we're on to the O. We are in the home stretch. The O is to optimize cognitive activity. And what do I mean by this? You want to train the brain, right? You want to give the brain activities to do. You want to train the brain. So for example, learning a new language, learning to dance because you're going to have to learn the choreography, right? Learning to play a new instrument. There was actually a study done on these London taxi drivers many years ago before GPS was a thing, right? And what they found was that these taxi drivers had the parts of their brain that had to do with memory was much bigger than the average. And what they thought was this was because these people were having to troubleshoot all the time. They had to learn, for example, street names and how to get to different places. They had to memorize things. And by doing that, the brain, the part of the brain that had to do with memory was actually bigger. And their cognitive abilities were better. So train the brain by doing things that stimulate the brain, right? Learn a new language, learn a new dance, all that stuff. And the last thing, the N in neuron, is to nurture your passion. You know, when they've looked at elderly people, the ones that are feisty and energetic and living their lives are actually the ones who have a passion. They have a reason for living. They get up every day with this passion in mind, right? The Japanese call it the ikigai. It's your reason for living. When you have a reason for living and a passion, right, your brain will also connect, your mind will connect, and you'll find that your cognitive health will be better. So find a reason for living. So again, the six tips, right? N-E-U-R-O-N. So the N is for nutrition. The E is for exercise. The U is to unwind, because we live in this stressful society, right? N-E-U. The R is for restorative sleep, and not just the quantity of sleep, but the quality of sleep, right? The O is to optimize brain health. And we talk about really training the brain, keeping the brain active, right? And the N is to nurture your passion. So there you have it. Thank you for joining me. Please don't forget to click to get your free gift, your free ebook from me. And you want to keep coming back, because here's what's going to happen. The year is coming to an end. I know how that is for many people. We have a 7-day jump start that's coming up. It's free. It's me and you and other people in the group for 7 days trying to get you healthy and keep you healthy, because you know that is my passion. So make sure that you're coming back, and do me a favor, share this page, share this video. There's someone else out there. So even if you know this stuff, there's someone else out there who doesn't. So go ahead and share this. A friend of mine said, sharing is caring. Share this video. We share bad news all the time, right, on our pages. Share this, because someone will learn something. And thank you so much. My website is Dr. Diane Thompson. That's D-R-D-I-A-N-E-T-H-O-N-P-S-O-N. And thanks for joining me. Take care.